Expressing her satisfaction with the increasing number of exam participants, the Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni, lauded the 12% increase in candidature, which rose from 97,890 in 2022 to 110,553 in 2023. Mrs. Museveni also commended the performance of female candidates, highlighting the growing recognition of their inherent potential. However, she lamented the persistence of gender stereotypes, acknowledging that these society biases may be preventing girls from fully realizing their capabilities.
Therefore, our system must figure out ways of enabling and empowering the girls to realize their full potential.
With many qualified students aspiring to pursue university education, the education minister urged them to consider alternative pathways, emphasizing the rewarding opportunities available in technical and health training institutions.
There are many rewarding opportunities in other tertiary institutions, such as our technical training colleges and health training institutions, that I would urge our young people to consider.
Traditionally, Ugandan students completing A-level have fixated on university admission, relegating technical education to a secondary option. Yet, there is a shifting paradigm in community perception, with technical and vocational education and training gaining traction as a viable career path, even among high achievers. However, amid the celebrations, challenges persist. The Minister for Education highlighted concerns about some head teachers failing in their duties as the first inspectors of their schools.
Some head teachers have forgotten that they are the first inspector of their schools. Where there is good leadership, the A's are many. Where there are no A's, to me, there is a problem with the leadership there.
Celestino Oboa, the chairperson UNEB, emphasized a significant increase in candidature, but expressed disappointment over the persistently lower entries for sciences compared to humanities.
The board notes that entries for sciences at UACE continue to be lower than for humanities. It is gratifying, though, that the numbers are going up. Honorable Minister, the performance of the candidates has improved, especially at the upper level of candidates obtaining three principal passes.
On a positive note, he announced the exceptional performance of candidates at Luzira Upper Prison, where all students passed the USCE examinations.
Luzira Upper Prison is not only a place for incarceration, but a true correctional center. As will be reported in the release statement, all candidates who sat the UACE from the prison passed, a testament to the efforts they have made to change for the better.
UNEB has rescheduled the examination from June, July to October to November 2024, ensuring that all potential beneficiaries of this education opportunity have ample time to register and excel.
This examination has now been moved from the original period of June, July 2024 to October, November 2024. It will now run alongside the 2024 Uganda Certificate of Education Examination. The registration period will also be the same as that for the 2024 examination.
Report compiled by Sharon Navasidi for the news.